Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. Let's say you're an infectious disease with dreams of spreading as far and wide as possible. Your logical starting point might be to invade a host and make as many mini-yous as fast as you can to spread to as many other hosts as you can. However, that would probably be counterproductive because the more of yourself you make, the worse your host feels. And the worse they feel, the less likely they are to go out and interact with other potential hosts. That's a problem if you're like most pathogens and require close contact, like a handshake, a shared drink, or something more intimate to move from host to host. This reliance on close contact imposes a major constraint. Most diseases have to limit the damage they inflict in order to keep their hosts feeling well enough and alive enough to drag themselves out of bed and into contact with other potential hosts. That's why most diseases, even if they aren't fun, usually only cause limited harm. But there are pathogens that can get around much more freely, and they're able to get really nasty. Like cholera, some strains of this diarrhea-causing bacteria can kill their hosts in a matter of hours. Since the disease can move through water, hosts don't have to be particularly mobile to transmit it. In fact, sicker hosts poop more bacteria into the water supply, diarrheaing even more people. So cholera is free to replicate with abandon and inflict serious damage. The same is true for diseases transmitted by flies, mosquitoes, and other creepy crawlies, which can access even super sick hosts and easily spread the pathogen around, and for diseases that can linger in the environment for years waiting for a new host. In general, pathogens that can be passed along at a distance or after long periods of time tend to be more lethal than those that require close contact. Yet we may be able to tame these diseases by imposing the constraint of direct contact. For example, in the 1990s, a cholera epidemic in South America spread from places where bacteria could move freely through the water supply to areas where better sanitation practices made waterborne transmission impossible. There, since cholera had to rely on decent-feeling hosts to spread, it evolved into a milder strain. So interventions for deadly diseases, like cleaning up water supplies, or, say, using bed nets regularly to keep insects away, can not only keep people from getting sick, they can also turn deadly diseases into diseases that only make people moderately sick. And that's an exciting germ of an idea.